Hi everyone, Jane from Pandemonium Art Gallery here, and today I'm going to show you how to paint this awesome autumn forest scene. In this video, we're going to focus on a few different things. The first is atmospheric perspective. We're going to work on color mixing and also using a palette knife. So check out the description below for all of the materials that you'll need, and let's get started. For this painting today, we are going to be using titanium white, burnt umber, phthalo green, alizarin crimson, cadmium orange, and yellow ochre, or yellow oxide, it depends on the brand that you buy. I am going to be using a tiny hint of Mars black also, but really just the smallest amount, so I haven't even put it out on my plate yet. The brushes we're going to use are a 1-inch flat brush, a 1/2-inch angle brush, and then a small round brush. This one says it's a number 4. We're also going to be using a palette knife. I'm also painting on a 16x20-inch stretched canvas. You can paint on any size of canvas that you like. We're actually going to paint the ground at the top. We're going to paint it upside down. I'm going to put down a base color first. So I've got my 1-inch brush, and I'm going to come over here to the brown, and I'm going to get quite a bit of brown. I did wet this brush in the jar of water and then just wiped it off on the edge. So it's damp, but it's not dripping. So I have burnt umber on one side, and I'm gonna get alizarin crimson on the other side. I'm gonna mix some of that green in there with the red. Now I'm gonna start at the top, and I'm just gonna go side to side. The reason I mixed all of those colors together is because the green and red work against each other. The red by itself is too bright, the green by itself is too bright. But together, even with the brown, they're too bright. But together, they help darken and deepen the color. I'm not too terribly worried about how this looks because I'm going to paint another layer over this that's going to make it really dark. I'm just worried about getting it covered. So I'm using both sides of the brush, putting some good pressure on there to get all the paint possible off of the brush and onto the canvas. Every time I go back for more, I get all three colors. So that is how you actually darken colors effectively. It's not by adding black. Black will not darken every color. For example, if you add black to this alizarin crimson, you get kind of a weird purple color. If you add black to yellow, you get olive green. So black does not necessarily make a darker version of whatever color you're using. The opposite color of that color makes it darker. So if you want to darken yellow, get a darker version of yellow, then you actually mix a little bit of purple with it. I wanted a darker version of this green, so I added the red to it. So now I'm going to let that dry, and then when it's dry, I'm going to add one more layer, and then we'll work on the sky. So this is dry now, and I've got it covering about 1/3 of the canvas. So I'm going to take the same color combination, the brown, green, and red, and I'm going to put another layer over it so that it's not quite so transparent and it's much darker. Then I'm going to get some white and start blending into the sky. So I'm going to use a little bit more paint this time because I'm really going to lay it on thickly. I've got my brown, got my alizarin crimson, and my phthalo green. And I'm just going to layer this really quickly. the rest of that covered and I'm at the line. I'm gonna extend past that line just a little bit. Not much, just a little bit. And let the color start to taper out. And now I'm gonna grab some white, quite a bit of white. I'm gonna start just below where I left off and I'm gonna go back and forth up into it just until that line starts to blend. And then right back down. I'm just trying to create a horizon line that is nice and soft. And I did not wash my brush off before I did this. That's gonna help me make sure that my white that I'm using for the sky doesn't stay pure white, that it still has some of those colors streaked through it. So I'm gonna keep going with this. And I want it to be a little lighter down here toward the horizon, a little bit more of a true white. So I'm not putting a lot of pressure on my brush. I'm really just using the end of the brush, not the whole flat part. As I decide I want a little bit more color, I can push a little bit harder and get some of that green and brown and red mixture. See how I've got some of that in there now? And that's all I'm gonna use for this whole sky. Just when I feel like I need a little bit more color, I'll just push a little bit harder, and there it is. Toward the bottom, I might add a little bit. We'll see how much is left in my brush when I get there. Because I want it to be darker at the top of the sky, which remember, we're painting this upside down. We're gonna turn it over in a minute. This is the ground. Push pretty good there and get some more of that color. So remember, you push flat with your brush to lay down color, and then you use just the end of the brush to blend the colors together. So here I'm just using the end of the brush to blend. And here I'm using the brush flat to lay down. And you can see all of that color still in my brush here. I'm gonna push pretty hard there in the first place to get a lot of that brown in there. Blend out that white line with the end of the brush. So there is our ground and our sky. Now I'm gonna let this dry completely before we move on to the next part. What we're gonna do now is create perspective and distance with some trees. We're gonna paint in a bunch of trees here. And the technique we're gonna be focusing on is called atmospheric perspective. So what that means is that the farther things are away from you, the more faded out they're gonna be because of the amount of atmosphere between the object and you. So we're gonna create some trees over here. These trees are gonna be a little bit shorter and they're gonna start a little higher on the horizon, but the color is gonna be really faint, not much darker than the sky here. As those trees move this way, they're gonna start getting a little bit bigger, a little bit darker, and they're gonna start growing in a little bit more below the horizon until we get over to this side where we're gonna have a large tree that starts right about in here. It's gonna be much wider, it's gonna be much taller, a lot darker, and it's gonna have some more details to it. So that's gonna help give us the impression that we're looking at a forest that is moving quite a ways back from us. So when we're painting the trees, I don't want you to put too much focus into what the trees actually look like. The things I want you to focus on are the size of the trees, and the color of the trees.
So first I'm gonna take the brush and I'm gonna dip it in my water. And then I'm just gonna wipe off a little bit just to make sure that there's not a drip. Now to create these trees, I'm gonna mix up a color fairly similar to this, just a little bit darker. Got my brush that's wet. I'm gonna grab a little bit of brown. Green and a little bit of red. And then I'm going to come over to my white and pull out just a little bit and mix it there until it's the color I want. Just a tiny bit more green and a tiny bit more brown over into that. And it doesn't matter what color you prefer. My background is a little on the greener side, so I don't want my trees to be too terribly red. And I kind of like that color, so I'm gonna bring a little more white into it so it's nice and light. And then I'm gonna bring one more drop of water into that and mix it so this paint has a nice flow to it, almost like ink. So I'm gonna start these trees right here on the horizon, and I'm using this angle brush, and I'm not using it flat. I'm gonna use the chisel edge with the tip pointing down since I'm starting at the bottom. Now, I can start off using the entire edge on the canvas like that, but when I get to the branches, I'm gonna lighten my pressure so that only about that much of the brush is touching the canvas. So there's a branch. There's a branch, a little one off of that. Don't put too terribly much detail into these. These are pretty far away, so you wouldn't really see a lot of detail on them. So I'm just gonna add a few. Putting a lot of attention into these trees and just getting them on there. I want them to almost look ghostly and make sure that they're staggered around so that they're not all the same distance apart, or they're not all the same height. Bring them almost to the middle, right about to the center. It will take a little bit of practice before you can draw trees this confidently. I paint a lot of trees, so I have a lot of practice with it. So feel free to get a junk canvas and just practice. Doesn't matter what color you use, you don't have to try and set up a scene or a painting. Just get a brush like this, get whatever color of paint, and just practice these brush strokes. That's it. Now I'm gonna make a few more trees that are a little darker and a little bigger, and they start a little lower. And they're gonna start right about here, just off of the center, and I'm gonna do fewer of them. I'm not gonna do that many. So these trees I'm doing now are gonna appear closer. So I'm just gonna mix up a slightly darker version of what I used for the last trees. If you're one of those people who really hates it when their food touches, you might have a hard time mixing up tons of really strange colors that you wouldn't think of mixing together, but don't be afraid of it, just do it. I'm gonna mix another drop of water into there just to make sure that it's got a nice flow. And if I test it and it's not dark enough, that's not a big deal, I can add more. So I'm gonna start lower. That is definitely not dark enough. Start a little bit lower there, and I'm going to make this tree base a little bit wider by pushing a little harder on my brush, and this tree is going to be taller. I might put just a little bit more attention into this tree than the back ones. Since it's closer, you would see more details. It's a little lower than that one, just to give the sense that they're growing in different spaces. You know, if you start them all on this perfectly horizontal line, then it's just gonna look flat and uninteresting. So even though they're existing on different planes, like these are all close to the horizon, I still staggered the bases. These are farther down from the horizon, but the bases are still staggered. Normally I would put more detail and attention into my trees, but we're really just, the focus is just creating distance. In a mood. Let's add one more, maybe a little closer here. And I think this one will be a little shorter. Maybe he's broken or just younger. Now I'm gonna mix up an even darker color and I'm gonna do one or two here. And I'm not actually going to bring any more white into this. I'm just going to mix the additional colors in with the paint that I had there. So again, I'm going to start a little lower this time with this tree, and that's actually not even dark enough. Starting lower and wider for sure. Don't worry about what the bottom of these trees looks like. You're not gonna see any of that. Definitely taller. Notice I'm wiggling my brush back and forth a little bit more. Gives it some of these little elbows, a little bit more detail in the tree than some of these distant ones. My mind. I'm going to make one more small dark one here. It's okay if it feels like it's getting lost in the trees behind it, because in a real forest, right, you would have very little distinction between trees sometimes. Now I'm gonna clean off my brush. Now we're gonna do our main tree right here, and I'm gonna have it start right about here. I'm gonna mix up some brown, some green, and red. And remember I told you that we were gonna use a tiny bit of black later. Now is where we're gonna use a tiny bit of black. So I just kind of scraped off the tip of that black blob there. And this paint is free from white. It's just brown, green, red, and black. And this tree's gonna be quite wide, and you almost can't tell a difference on the ground here with it. And that's fine, I'm not worried about that. You'll be able to tell a difference in a little bit. this color is really transparent. But I'm not worried about it because since this is our tree in the foreground, we're gonna add a little bit more detail to it. I'm gonna add some highlights to it that the other trees don't have. And that's really gonna help set it apart from everything else. Try and make some branches that go off of the edge of your canvas. That's really interesting to the eye. And it makes you not feel trapped inside of an image. Now I am gonna grab just a tiny bit of white and kind of slash down over top of it in a few places. I'm not adding white to all of it. If it gets too light, I'm just gonna grab some more of my dark color. Just make sure it stays nice and dark. I can even add a tiny bit more black in there if I want to. Just giving a few highlights here and there. Just smeared a wet tree. All right, take this brush that's damp but clean, and remember we can just scrub right up to it. Now it's gone. Just keep adding those highlights wherever you feel like you need them. And if you feel like you don't need them, then don't add them. If you're painting this another time of year and you're not feeling the fall colors, it's not what you want to see, you could definitely do this with, you know, more springy or bright type colors. You could do this with greens and yellows, and you know, you can experiment with it, and whatever color combinations you choose to use, it's going to yield a different type of feel. I'm really excited about fall, so this is exactly what I want to see today. I'm going to put just a couple brighter spots down here in the trunk, and then we'll be done. So now you can kind of start to see how we've created some distance here. These trees look like they're much farther away, and then they start to get larger and more detailed as they come forward. So that's going to tell us that this ground is all farther away from us, that we're standing over here viewing it from this angle rather than standing directly in front viewing it like that. This is our closest main focus tree, and these are the distant ones. That's going to keep your eye kind of moving in that direction while keeping it anchored here. So now I'm going to let this dry again, because the next part is we're going to add the leaves to the ground, the leaves that have dropped off of these trees. And so I want all of this to be dry because we're going to be working right over top of those tree trunks. Now we're going to start adding our foliage to this darker area here. And again, I've got the camera zoomed in really far so that you can see exactly how I'm using the palette knife. For the ground, we're going to use two tools specifically. We're going to use a palette knife. This is the one that I prefer, but it doesn't really matter. Whatever shape you choose to use. I'm mostly going to be using this edge here. On this side, I'm going to be putting paint on this side so that when I hold it, I can use the palette knife like this. We're also going to need this little round brush, and what this is for is rather than trying to just put the foliage in between the trees here, because I want it to go all the way up against the tree. So it looks like the trees, it looks like the foliage is also existing behind these trees here. So we're gonna use this as we get our foliage colors over top of our trunks. We're gonna wet this brush down and just wipe it off. So don't worry about getting the colors on top of the trunks here. This, like I said here, is gonna be our darkest area, and it's slowly gonna get brighter and more intense color as we go this way, but also this way. So my first colors back here, I'm gonna focus on is brown. So I'm gonna get a little bit of brown along the edge of my palette knife. It's not much, it's very, very little paint. Just a tiny bit. If you get too much, just kinda pat it off on there. And then I'm gonna get some green. That's gonna make a pretty dark color. I'm not gonna add any red right now because I want it to almost fade into this background part here. Now, when I hold this palette knife, I'm gonna hold it like this. And I don't know if you can tell, see my fingers are extending past the handle. I'm not holding it like this so that I can get it perfectly flat on the canvas. I'm holding it like that so that when I put my hand to the canvas, my fingers stop the palette knife. The important thing here is you do not want to touch the palette knife to the canvas. Doing so is going to scrape paint off. We're only interested in laying down tiny bits of paint and then we're going to smear them. But we're not going to scrape paint onto here. I'm going to come in here and I'm just going to lightly tap, just very lightly, tiny little blobs of color. And then I'm going to smear across them, just lightly drag that paint. Wet off my little round brush, and then I dried it on my paper towel a little bit. I'm going to come in here and just wipe that off. Wipe that paint off of my paper towel. Wipe it off the trunk. And you want to do this immediately. Don't let that paint dry. If it dries, it will not come off. And you can always paint your tree back in. Then the base of your tree is gonna look different unless you happen to get the exact same color that you did before. Smaller trees are a little more difficult. Once we get to the larger trees in the front, it's easier to get the paint off of them. You can blot it with your finger a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna continue. I'm gonna go all the way across. So just a little bit of brown and a little bit of green. And then I'm gonna gently, see how I'm barely touching it? I'm just getting these tiny little specks of the color there. And then streak it across. That sound you hear that sounds like I've got the palette knife dragging across the canvas, that's my fingertips on the canvas. Now that I'm almost halfway, I'm gonna start picking up just a tiny bit more paint. As I move across, I'm gonna pick up more and more paint because I want the ground area here to appear larger. So where I've got these teeny tiny little specks, I want larger ones over here. Now that I'm just past the halfway point, I'm gonna pick up a little less green. I'm still gonna get my brown. Brown is kind of my base color at this point. A little bit more brown than I have been getting. A little bit of green, not a lot. And I'm gonna actually pick up a little bit of nice crimson color. And I can start putting a little bit more pressure to make those blobs of paint a little bit heavier. And then just streak across them. I think I actually got a little carried away with the red there, so I'm gonna go back over it with just a little bit of brown and green. So if you end up getting too much of one color or not enough of another, it's fine. Just add more. Just be careful that you don't paint over your entire background, all of this color. You want a little bit of that to show through because that's what's going to give you the basis for all of your other colors. Otherwise, then you just have these brighter colors that are kind of floating. It'll look a little more flat. So again, I'm gonna start over here and I'm gonna work my way this way. And remember, as we work down from here, these little spots are gonna get a little bit bigger and a little bit brighter. I'm only gonna go into the red really down here, maybe a tiny hint of the orange. Over here on this side, it's gonna move into the red really quick and it's gonna end on this gold color. And this gold color is not going to extend past the center point. So this corner right here is gonna be really bright. I think I'm going to leave that one. At some point, you want the trunks to disappear under the foliage colors. Just covered the base of this little tree. I'm not worried about that. I'm gonna let it be like that. Don't be afraid to tap your colors up into the previous section. That'll help you keep from getting like a line where maybe you just transitioned into red and you didn't use red in the previous section. If you don't tap up into that a little bit, you're gonna have a hard line where all of a sudden there's red, and it's gonna be really jarring and take away from the overall effect that you're going for. I feel like I don't have enough red up in here, so I'm gonna grab a little bit more. I really want the red to kind of be the driving color here at the top. Again, I'm going to start over here. I've still got some red on here, but that's okay because I'm starting to bring a little bit of red down into there. this way. And just put a little bit more pressure on that paint so that the blobs are a little bit bigger. Start phasing green out. Of course, I've still got some green on my brush or my palette knife, and there's a little green mixed in with some of the red and brown on my plate. So that'll give me just enough green. Green this time. What I am going to do is I'm going to start picking up hint. Oh, my orange dried out a little bit. I'm gonna pick up a tiny hint of orange, just a tiny bit. I'm gonna start introducing that. So I don't know if you can tell on here, but I've only covered about that much of the ground over there, as opposed to about that much of the ground over here. So almost twice. So I'm trying to keep the same focus here, where I made these trees shorter and these trees much taller. I'm doing the same thing here, working in really small sections and slowly working into larger sections, dark to light. So this might be slightly challenging for you if you're not used to focusing on what your colors are doing or what your perspective is doing, but it's a really good exercise for you. Mess with it a lot. I painted this painting in several different ways, probably 8 or 9 times, trying to work up how to do it for this video. So, you know, just experiment with it and practice until you feel comfortable with it. And it's quite possible that what you end up with won't be anything like what you were going for in the first place. But that doesn't mean you won't be happy with it. You'll find what makes you happy and what you like to do, what's comfortable for you. This painting is actually nothing like it was when I first started working on it. And then every time I paint it, it's a little bit different again. All right, again, now that I'm at the halfway point, I'm not gonna pick up any green. I'm just gonna go right into my red. And I think just a tiny hint of orange here. I'm gonna start introducing that into the middle. And now here, because I'm picking up more paint, my foliage is starting to look bigger. My streaks are bigger. Just a little bit of brown this time. I'm gonna pick up mostly red. A good amount of orange. I'm gonna pick up just red now. I'm not even gonna pick up any brown. I've still got green and brown and whatever in my red here, so that'll be enough for me. And some orange. Start working the green out over there. So I've got brown and red. And I can start making these blobs a little bit bigger. And actually, I'm a little lower than those, so I'm going to take it up just a bit. bottom of that tree be covered. As I work toward the middle here, I'm picking up less orange, focusing more on the red. Here and I'm just adding orange. I've got all my other colors still on my palette knife. But I'm going to start really focusing on orange on this side. It's quite a bit of orange and a little bit of red. Looking into some brown as I get to the center here. Remember that sound there? See, I'm not even touching. It's my fingers. It's not this part of the palette knife. I am not scraping it. So if you were to scrape it, here's what would happen. It takes the paint off. Or it will make it really thin and you can see the texture of the canvas through it. And that's going to take away the illusion that you have just nicely scattered leaves here. I'm going to add just a little bit of orange into here. Not much. Just to keep it a little on the bright side. Not so much that it detracts from this left side, where I really want all the brightness. Right here in the middle, I think I'm just gonna come down with some red. I'm actually gonna have this corner fade back out into brown. Get some more orange from this side. And now I'm gonna start working in some of this gold. This gold is really only going to exist over here. Orange, yellow, and a hint of red. A little brown, because I'm going to start fading this back. Dark. Not as dark as up here, just darker. I just want this orange to exist here and there throughout this front portion. And that's not because I want to see the orange there, but because I want to keep it from looking too flat. So even though I want this side to seem darker, I'm going to throw a tiny bit of green in here. Even though I want this side to seem darker, I still want that little bit of orange because it keeps it from looking flat and boring. See if there's any spots where I want to add a little bit more of something. I think I do. I want to bring some orange up here just a bit. The yellow is kind of what's at our feet. We're standing here, that's what this yellow would be, is the leaves at our feet. Okay, we have one last thing to do and then we are done. So I'm gonna take this round brush. I'm gonna mix up a color similar to these colors that we did for the trees. A little bit of brown, a little bit of green, a little bit of red. A drop of water. And on this tree in the front, I'm gonna add some leaves, just a few leaves that are clinging on here and there. I might have a couple that are falling, I might have a couple that are blowing away to that side. And to do leaves, I'm just gonna touch just really random shape, just kind of wherever I feel like they need to be. So they don't have to be attached to anything. Some that are blowing away, they're going to be a little bit larger toward the tree, again, maintaining that perspective. And they're going to be smaller as they go that way. Okay, I've cleaned off my brush. I'm going to get a little of the crimson by itself, and I'm just going to add little dots of color randomly. I'm not gonna put this color on every leaf. And even the leaves that I am putting the color on, it's not necessarily covering it. It might be slightly off of it. It might cover all of it. It might cover a tiny bit of it. Get some orange. I did not clean off my brush. Just grabbing some of this orange. And you can even add it to leaves that you've already put red on. Right, they're fall leaves, so they would have all kinds of colors going on in there. You don't have to put color on all of the leaves. You can leave some of them the brown color if you want. I kind of like to put the color on all of them, but that's just my preference. And see, even when I put this color on, some of it is outside of the line, some of it's bigger than the brown spot. That's okay. Gold. And watch how much these leaves start to pop when we start putting gold on them. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed learning about atmospheric perspective and how to use a palette knife. And if you were a little squeamish about mixing weird colors together, I hope that I was able to help you get over that today too. Feel free to experiment with this painting, and maybe it would be fun to do a few of them, one for each season. Please make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe, and let me know if there are any videos that you would like to see. And please make sure that you check out the description below that has all of the information regarding the materials that I use, links to my website and Facebook, the music that I use in the videos, and everything else. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.